Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of colors and remain standing for the national anthem.
If you could just bear with us one moment, she's on her way to the stage. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. At this time, while you all are our special guests today, I would like to introduce some distinguished guests that are here with us for our culminating event, also known as graduation. At this time, I would like to introduce to you our board member, Mrs. Deidre Pierce. Ms. Pierce, if you could stand and be recognized at this time. Also, I would like to introduce to you our regional superintendent for Region 7, Dr. Rodney Swanson. Dr. Swanson, please stand at this time. Thank you. We are honored to have them here with us as we celebrate this momentous occasion.
Good afternoon, students, family members, teachers, and all guests of the McNair family. I am Luis Marcel Guzman and McNair's class of 2021 salutatorian. And I am glad to welcome you to this year's graduation. I'd like to congratulate every single student who is here as we take our next steps into the real world. I would also like to thank everybody here who's come to watch the students graduate. It means much not only to me, but every single student here. I would like to give a special thanks to the teachers that have watched me grow over the years, such as Ms. Glover, Dr. Perkins, Ms. Ward, Mr. McPhail, and many others. I am proud to have such amazing teachers over the years who not only watched me grow academically, but as a person. I would like to give the biggest thanks to my parents, however, who never gave up on me and made it possible for me to be here. I know they struggled as immigrants, and they gave everything that they could to make sure I would be successful one day, and I won't let that sacrifice go to waste. The class of 2021 has shown perseverance throughout this year, as not even a quarantine was able to stop us from graduating. Graduation is only a stepping stone for us, however. There is more for us to accomplish, more goals to reach, and more people to meet. Whether it be through military service, going to the workforce, or college, we still have a mark to leave on the world. It wasn't easy making it here. Countless nights of doing work, trying to adapt to the life of quarantine, balancing school as well as time for myself. This year has been unpredictable. Regardless, I will continue to strive forward and make sure the sacrifices of my parents weren't in vain. I thank God for giving me this opportunity to speak to everybody here and class of 2021. I wish to continue to see you making a name for yourselves. Let's prove to the world McNair High School is taking a turn for the better and prove that this graduation class will be the best the world has to offer.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kobe Sitwell, and I am the class valedictorian for the class of 2021. It is a pleasure to see such a turnout today from so many of our loved ones and supporters. This past year has been filled with challenges and hardships that have surely worn us all out. A pandemic, an election, shootings, and a vast array of events we have witnessed across the nation and the world. It was frightful, tense, and at times it may seem that there was no hope. But that fear did not come true. Despite the perils we have faced and the sacrifices committed, our class has reached this day, a day some of us may have thought we would never get to see. Today marks a transition in our lives, ready to enter the next phase in our grand journey. We made it through 2020, haven't we? Who's to say we aren't prepared for the next challenge life has to throw at us? Now here we are, 15 months later, preparing to embark on the next chapter of our lives. We have persevered. As I look at the faces before me, I realize that I am surrounded by young men and young women with a will of iron, a class determined to see their dreams through and fulfill them to the end. I see a class full of ambitious and brilliant minds that will go on to become doctors, psychologists, business administrators, bioengineers, and so much more. I've never seen a class more inspired, creative, empowered, and capable of changing the world than the one I stand before today. After spending 4 years with all of you, I can safely say that every single one of you holds an artistic strength. This year's class is accomplished in various areas, and I can only imagine what each of you goes on to do with those talents of yours years from now. Talents. Without talents, how could we have the society we live in today? Who would design and construct the infrastructure we use daily, provide the medical treatments that we need to survive, develop the technology we spend so much time sticking our faces into, create the entertainment we know and love? People, without talents coming from someone, nobody in this stadium would be where they're at right now. Those talented people who've come before us changed the world with their brilliance. And that same brilliance lies within the hearts and minds of each and every one of us. Put that talent of yours to greater use. Strive to excel in what you do best. Remember, while talent may come naturally, skill and proficiency in controlling that talent requires development and practice. You must invest the time, dedication, patience, and passion for achieving mastery over one's gifts. To quote a famous actor, Will Smith, talent you have naturally. Skill is only developed by hours and hours and hours of beating on your own craft. Only you can decide what to do and how to use your strengths and the capacity that they can reach. Our choices make us who we are, and you choose to follow through on your ambitions. Expand your repertoire of knowledge and take up exciting opportunities of gain. Explore the new trails that have opened for you to follow and are vital to obtaining a satisfying and successful life. Nurture your gifts with practice and passion, and I promise that all the effort you put into succeeding will be worth it. The world is a constantly changing place, and you will always leave an impact on it, no matter whether the actions you take are massive or minuscule. Work to change this planet for the better. Even the tiniest acts you commit, the talent that you have in you, is sure to impact at least one person's life. Have a good day, my friends, and I wish you all successful and happy lives.
Good afternoon to everyone. To our superintendent, Mrs. Cheryl Watson Harris, our board member, Mrs. Deirdre Pierce, our region superintendent, Dr. Rodney Swanson, the administrative team, faculty and staff at Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School, parents, families, community members, and especially the class of 2021, welcome. Today's graduation ceremony is both the culmination of years of hard work and the recognition of goals achieved. Therefore, it's only fitting that this afternoon we celebrate the passage that we have traveled together these last 12 to 14 years. For many, this ceremony is an occasion for which we have been waiting. This occasion makes me think of a baseball or a softball game where some hit a home run and made it to home plate with ease. Some made it to the home plate by running one or two bases at a time. Oh, but there were some of you who slid into home just in the nick of time. Nevertheless, a touch at home plate is the same for everyone, and the outcome is the same. Ladies and gentlemen, it is called graduation. You made it. As always, I charge myself with finding the appropriate parting words for you to take on your lifelong journey. Although there are many great things to say, I want the message to be well-timed and impactful. Because life has a way of taking you through paths of triumphs, trials, successes, heartbreaks, joys, and more, I decided to give you a gift that life, struggles, and accomplishments have taught me: wisdom. Many of you realize that this last year or two have been unlike any other. We have dealt with loss on a scale few of us could ever imagine. Financial loss, human loss, mental health setbacks, and several other losses have greatly affected life as we knew it prior to the pandemic. Even today, as we are here to celebrate this moment of achievement, many of us are sitting near others who know nothing or very little about some of our life's struggles. They simply don't know your true story. But let me share that it's not as important for them to know your story as much as it is necessary for them to know who you became in the process. Life has a way of teaching you important lessons in ways that will cause you to change forever. Even though you are graduating from high school, in many ways your life lessons are only beginning. So let me give you some pointers on how to navigate through lessons so that you will always come out on top. When the stresses of life come, they seem to weigh you down, and in some ways, you will feel buried. But being buried, surprisingly, isn't always a bad thing. Conquering life's challenges can be as simple as changing your perspective. What do you mean? Well, I'm glad you asked. Think about growing something, whether it's plants, trees, vegetables, or anything else. You first have to plant seeds. Seeds have to be buried. That means that the seed is covered in dirt, and sometimes the dirt is not just thrown on the seed, but pressed down to ensure that it can't escape the area it has been held captive. Indeed, the seed has been buried. Most of the time, however, when you think of growing plants or trees or fruits or vegetables, we don't think buried. We think planted. The seeds are planted so that the process of watering and fertilizing can take place while it is covered by dirt. No one can see it yet, but something amazing is happening in the dirt. After a while, and in the process of time, we begin to see something emerging from the dirt. It doesn't look like anything like its final stage, but we see something that we haven't seen before. It's growing, it's changing, it's emerging, it is simply becoming. This is the difference between being buried versus being planted. This pandemic did not bury you. Losing loved ones did not destroy you. Having an extremely difficult senior year did not kill you. However, it allows you to be planted. Planted so that you can grow and become who and what you are destined to be. Navigating life successfully is about changing your perspective. When you're buried, you see defeat. But when you're planted, you see opportunity. Opportunity to make changes in your attitude, adjust your routine, change your friends, make better decisions, and settle on your next steps to complete your life's goals. If you don't remember anything else today, I want you to be encouraged, inspired, and determined to always view life as an opportunity to be better than you were the day before. May your years be filled with a willingness to take risk, the drive to succeed, and most importantly, the willingness to give back to those less fortunate. It has been an honor and a privilege watching your progress and your success. I am proud to have served as your principal. speaking of successes, the class of 2021 has great honors. The academic and financial summary is as follows. Of the 93 graduates today, 5 are receiving diplomas with honors with distinction, 85 college prep diplomas, 1 career technical diploma, and 2 exceptional education diplomas. For post high school, 40 of our graduates have chosen to attend a 4-year college or university. 5 have chosen to attend a 2-year technical community college. 8 have chosen to attend technical schools or otherwise specialty schools. 8 have chosen to enter the military directly. 10 will enter the workforce immediately, and 10 are yet undecided. For the academic scholarships that have been offered to this class of 93, with college acceptances to schools like Alabama A&M, Alabama State University, Georgia State University, Georgia Tech, Mercer University, Oglethorpe University, University of Georgia, just to name a few, have received scholarships well over $2 million. The scholarship total for the class of 2021 is $2,504,317. Congratulations once again to the class of 2021. Dr. Swanson, Mrs. Deirdre Pierce, and our superintendent in her absence, Mrs. Cheryl Watson-Harris, representing the faculty and administration of Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School, I do certify that these seniors have completed the requirements for the graduation as established by our accrediting agencies and by the DeKalb County Board of Education. So on their behalf, I respectfully request the release of the diplomas for the class of 2021.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm going to take a point of privilege here for a second to let you know that my daughter and son graduated from McNair High School. I was proud of it then, and I'm extremely proud of it still today. Graduates, I cannot tell you how proud I am of all of you. Family members, parents, friends, extraordinary faculty and staff, leadership of the building. Thank you for everything that you all have done to get our young people to this day. And with that, I'll carry on with my script. Dr. Walker, thank you for the information, and on the basis of your certification, I accept your recommendation. The academic achievement of this phenomenal class of scholars meets the course requirements as established by Advanced Ed, the Georgia Board of Education, the Georgia Accrediting Commission, and the DeKalb County Board of Education. As a very proud representative of the DeKalb County Board of Education, it gives me great pleasure and great honor to authorize the release and presentation of diplomas and certificates to this outstanding class of 2021 at Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School.
Colby Sidwell. Luis Marcel Guzman. Jamal Ray. Kiara Cartwright. Jason Brown. Jemiah Presley. Seth Smith. Claudia Durden. India James. La Petitris Binyard. Rayvon Bonner. Zion Boone. Keon Brewer. Essiana Bridges. Jalen Brown. Jared Davenport. Marcus Holmes. Harmony Hood. Jalen Isabel. DeAndre Maddox. Brianna Christmas. Shamaya Coleman. Jasmine Crawley. Jada High. Tiffany Robinson. Jamari Anderson. Vivian Bailey. Keandre Barnett. Bryant Barrera Vasquez. Vanessa Benson. Harvey Haynes. Mariana Gibson. Sanchez Gordon. Malachi Granberry. Samuel Granberry. April Green. Augustus Green. Matthew Griffin. Rashida Ivy. Jalen Jackson. Miracle Jarrett. Kamaris Johnson. Sedarius Johnson. Kenneth Marshall. Kyla Key Lewis. Leah Knox. Joshua Julius. Nicola Lawson. Kanae Lewis. Michaela Lewis. Carlos Lindsay. Marquez Mack. Zaire Hankerson. Kiara Haynes. Kayla Hurd. Charity Edie. Amari Eberhardt. Asia Ford. Jasmine Grant. Lyric Jones. Tamaya McBride. Tamaya McCummins. Martravia Meadows. Essence Moore. Ziana Nix. Jemiah Patman. Oh. Devin Russell. Sanaya Seagraves. Trinity Showers. Thad Smith. Anissa Spivey. Olivia Streeter. Aaliyah Sutton. Javon Yerby. Nivia Young. Kibi Zing. Freddie Gordon. Tierra Carswell. Destiny Thomas Andrews. Dynasty Thomas Andrews. Princess Torres. Taeja Ware. Kayla Westbrook. Tiana Williams. Michaela Respris. Michaela Reese. Zora Fagan. Ashanti Pinckney. Tierra Ransom. Atif Ray. Congratulations to the class of 2021.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Jamari Anderson, and the class of 2021, I'm gonna need for all y'all to please rise about your seats. My graduates, I'm gonna need for all you guys to rise and enjoy this day. I'm here today to complete one final thing, the most important thing, class of 2021. As we get ready to leave this field, always remember the talents and gifts you have inside of you. We are a special class, yes we are, and we made it. No other class can ever say that they've been through what we've been through, especially like what we've been through. and the 14 months of a pandemic. Class of 2021, before we leave this field, let's celebrate and show love to our families, teachers, and administrators. Let's thank them for all the support they've given us these last 4 years through all the ups and downs. And we thank you and may we salute you all today. Give a round of applause for everyone, everyone. That's what I'm talking about. Come on. Come on, y'all. Now, let's show the audience why we are the best class to ever step foot in Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School. With that being said, are y'all ready? Y'all ready? Hold on, hold on. Give it a second. Y'all ready? Y'all got your camera phones out. On the count of three, I want you to move your tassel from your right to your left. Y'all ready? Y'all ready? On the count of three. One, two, three. Let's go! Congratulations. Congratulations. Ooh. Congratulations. We are now the alumni of the Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School. And we got one last thing for all the parents out there. Mama, we made it. Peace out, everybody.
As we begin to conclude our program for this afternoon, I would also like to give a shout out to the amazing faculty and staff of Dr. Ronald E. McNair. Just as you, class of 2021, you've dealt with a year that has been filled with challenges, but also opportunities for us to learn more, to learn differently, and most importantly, do better. I must say that the faculty and staff of Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School entered into the pandemic with somewhat of a struggle. We all had to make changes. But when I tell you community members and families and parents that they rose to the occasion. So if you don't mind, before we close out today, and if you can, will you stand to your feet and give a round of applause to the faculty and staff of Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School. And while all of our teachers went the extra mile for all of our students, 9 through 12, I must say that our senior teachers went above and beyond. So for some of those that slid into home plate, they did it with the help of you. So teachers, thank you, and thank you. On that note, I would like to thank you all for attending our commencement ceremony. As you go your separate ways and begin to celebrate, celebration is awesome, it's fun, and I remember being in your seat. I loved receiving the money that came in those envelopes. But when your celebration is over, refocused, make the shifts that you need to make so that you can continue moving forward. And don't let anything stop you. So whatever you encounter, continue to move forward. Once again, on behalf of DeKalb County School District, Dr. Ronald E. McNair High School, our distinguished guests and faculty and staff, congratulations once again to the class of 2021. You made it.